As a connected educator, I've spent a great amount of time on Twitter connecting with genius educators from around the world, one of which is Angela Mayers. Angela has a very powerful message: you matter and the world needs your contribution. I've taken that to heart and brought that message back to my students and am challenging them to find what it is that moves them, to question and to go through a process to have an action that will impact the world. It all started with a pep talk from Kid President and gathering 95 sixth grade students together to hear his empowering message. Next, we brought the team together and gave them an opportunity to hear Angela's message firsthand. So, what happens when you know you matter and understand your actions count?
A little passionate about the topic of passion, so I might be able to say a couple things about it. I think the most important thing is to understand what passion is and what passion is not, because we tell people to follow passion, and it really takes us on a little bit of tangent. So I define passion as from the root word of passion, which is to suffer. And so obviously no one wants to follow suffrage, but it's in suffrage that we discover, you know, what we're really made of. We discover our extraordinary in just ordinary day to day. And so following passion to me is about following commitment and following dedication and figuring out what keeps you alive, what keeps you going. Passion isn't doing what you like to do or even what you're good at doing, because the moment those get hard or they become not as rewarding or you don't get as good in doing it as you were before, the moment people quit. When you're passion driven, quitting is never an option. It's akin to asking you not to breathe. So when you discover what it is that makes you as alive as the act of breathing, then you understand that you are on a path to evolving your passion, if you will. And so what makes me breathe is this work that we're doing. Teaching makes me breathe. Asking me to not teach or asking me not to be a part of the education community is akin to asking me not to breathe. And I think that it's really important that we stop trying to make passion so hard, and that trying to match, you know, passion is something that unearths itself when you're in the presence of other passionate people. It unearths itself when you're being called to do something that you not necessarily knew you were capable of. And so we orient kids toward passion by asking them not to follow their heart, but by asking them to follow heartbreak. And that when you follow heartbreak, you discover that you're needed. And that's what ignites you to get good at something. That's what ignites you to commit to something. That's what ignites you to wake up earlier than you knew or wanted to, because there's someone out there that needs exactly what you have. And so I think that's the most exciting thing about the web, is that it's not information driven, it's passion driven. And what it demands of us as citizens, not just as teachers or as students, is that we talk openly and honestly about what our passions are, what drives us, what motivates us, what compels us to do things that are hard and difficult and challenging. What are the things that we feel must be done in our lives and in the world? And sharing that openly and honestly and consistently on the web opens up unbelievable opportunities. It draws other passionate people in. It invites you to communities that are also driven by passion. And it absolutely changes your life. Passion changes the web and it changes your life. So please don't underestimate the value of your own passion and the passion that you will discover from your students by showing them yours.
Hershey Middle School students matter, so let's hear it from them.
Matter.
I matter.
I am genius.
I am genius.
I am genius and the world needs my contribution.
I am genius and the world needs my contribution.
So as the students were wrapping up their first round of passion projects, I created this Weebly, and every single student has a page where they were putting their final project, and then they could be clicked in and viewed from other students around the world. Feedback could be given or questions could be asked. And it was a really powerful experience for the students to see the impact that they could have. Here's an example of one of the students. Her first project was the Humane Society, and she had collected items and dropped them off and made an impact in her own way. And here she is talking about that project. So the students, after they shared their projects and their individual passions, they had an opportunity to then create a wall where they would show all of their passions and know who was an expert in what area. So I'm going to go down and show you our passion wall. So here is the passion wall, and each student filled out one of these papers and saying that they are great at, and this was their original one. But then around it, they actually put some other things that they're interested in. And that way, so as a team for our next round, if they wanted to work together with someone else, they could go to the passion wall and see what kind of, you know, similar contribution that other students might be interested in doing for round two. Another amazing project was done by this young lady collecting for Gambia, Africa. And what she did was she created a letter that she addressed to her neighbors. And it basically talked about her project and wanting to make an impact in a village that really was needy. And so she provided some facts on the country and asked for their help to drop off items that were needed. And you can see that there's school supplies and various types of personal items or, you know, things that can be used in their village, in their homes. And she then provided pictures and so forth. She had a contact who would deliver the items once she collected them by having her neighbors drop them off at her house. And then the person who took the items over provided pictures, and you can see the items that she collected, you know, at the village. But it was pretty cool when she had collected all of these things. I'll play this video. You can see the whole room is filled with items, and you know, if one 12-year-old child can make here, such an impact.
That's in the boxes for my project, my passion project. There in the boxes, there's like stuffed animal shoes, books. This one's specific on school supplies. This is another one, school supplies, clothes. Collected all different stuff.
So if she can do this, we can do this too. In the second round of passion projects, students were allowed to work together with others with similar passions. And here you see three of the girls that did a Pillows for Patients project. And their idea was that they wanted to bring some happiness to some patients who were experiencing illnesses. For example, they zeroed in on kids facing cancer. And they made and delivered pillowcases, and they didn't even know how to sew at first. So they found someone that could teach them, and they bought the materials, and they learned how to actually make their pillowcases. And here you can see that they're learning how to sew. And then they started to write encouraging words on the outside of each pillowcase. And then they delivered them to the individuals or families, telling them that they matter, and that here you can see this family is strong, and this lady is funny. And Gabe was one of our own at Hershey Middle School who was experiencing cancer, and they wanted him to know that he's awesome. And here, several different individuals, brave, fearless, sweet, cute. And the girls were so excited to have such an impact in a powerful way and experience that firsthand. So Cases for Faces was their project. Some other student projects included raising money for blood cancer. And what these students did, they made rainbow loom bracelets and necklaces, as well as crayon canvases, and then sold them at a drive in their neighborhood. And all of the money then was donated. A couple of young guys, they collected money and purchased at the dollar store different items and made baskets that were delivered to the children's hospital. This young lady set up online a donor's site and information to let others know about the need that animals have and how we can provide them with donation. And then it was given to Best Friend Animal Society. There were so many great projects that when we give students time and support, that their impact to change the world is valued and necessary. One of the projects that a student did that also had a huge impact on our local community was an anti-bullying message. The young man's video went viral, and people around the world were impacted by it, and it was shared in other schools as well as our own, and an advisory lesson was created around it. And I would like to leave you with this young man's message and how his impact, his genius, the world demanded this contribution, and it's powerful.
Why does my heart In fourth grade, I got picked on for being slow and clumsy. I was picked last for teams, laughed at in gym, and called names at recess. I was angry and sad a lot, and I felt alone. But that year helped me to see that I wasn't alone. A lot of kids get picked on and excluded just for being different. And I made it my mission to reach out to those kids, the lonely, rejected, and unpopular ones, and to speak life.
Some days life feels perfect, other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing, we can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable, broken, live or die. So speak life, speak life, to the daddy's darkest night. It's twisted. Other days, my thoughts just fall apart. I do, I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope you live or die. So speak life, speak life. To the deadest, darkest night. Speak life, speak life. Like the sun will shine and you don't know why. You say, raise your thoughts a little higher, use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher, spread the love like fire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. So speak life, speak life. Feels perfect.